covering more than 70% of the planet's surface. The ocean surrounds us and is essential to life. However, it also contains the most remote and least understood habitats on Earth. The majority of the ocean is very deep and remains largely unexplored. This is because of the difficulties working in such a harsh environment. In the mid-17th century, some researchers concluded that the deep sea was azoic, showing no traces of life. Part of this assumption was based on the lack of a food supply. With no light available down deep, food can't be produced through photosynthesis as it is in shallow water. Perhaps because it was so unimaginable, the idea of a lifeless deep sea persisted even in the face of evidence provided by earlier explorers who recovered remarkable animals like this basket star from deep water. With the advent of major research voyages, such as the four-year-long Challenger expedition, our understanding of life in the deep sea increased tremendously. Yet it would be nearly another century before technology allowed us to begin to visualize these remote ecosystems. Newer technologies, such as remotely operated submarines, reveal what was previously hidden. The deep sea actually contains a variety of remarkable habitats that support rich biological communities. We now know that even in the Mariana Trench, the deepest part of the ocean, there is life. Crustaceans and other species live nearly 7 miles down. As our vehicles descend into the ocean, light fades quickly. Temperatures drop to just above freezing, and the weight of the water above results in immense pressure. The vast abyssal area spans depths of 3,000 to 6,000 meters and comprises 76% of the entire ocean floor. Off the coast of California, researchers have studied an abyssal area for the past 24 years. Long thought to be a constant, unchanging environment, well isolated from changes taking place in the upper ocean, we now know that these areas can be dynamic and that the ecological changes there are linked to what is happening at the ocean's surface and, in fact, our whole global biosphere. We've learned that animals living in the abyss survive on organic matter created in shallow water that floats downward. Small bits of dead animals and single-celled marine algae make their way to the seafloor, providing food for other organisms that filter it out of the water or extract it from mud on the bottom. Fluctuations in the number of animals on the seafloor are tied to the amount of organic matter falling from above. The changes we saw in the latter part of the study were quite dramatic. In 2006, there was no obvious organic matter observed on the seafloor, and there were mostly immobile, filter-feeding animals living there. The number and types of animals stayed this way for some time, even during 2007, when we saw an increasing amount of organic matter on the seafloor. By 2009, the debris was no longer there, presumably having been eaten. Within 2 years, the biological community changed dramatically. Now, large numbers of sea cucumbers dominated the seafloor. More dramatic changes took place in 2012. In March, we saw a salp bloom. Salps are gelatinous animals that are most abundant in surface waters and whose numbers are known to increase rapidly. Over the next 2 months, many of them drifted downward. Certain types of seafloor animals capable of taking advantage of this extra food thrived, becoming more abundant than at any other time in this 24-year study. Other animals, such as sponges, became clogged and died. Our understanding of the deep sea is dependent on the development of technology. Autonomous vehicles like our benthic rover can move along the seabed, measuring how much food is consumed and how much is stored in the sediments for use by animals when less is raining down from above. Time-lapse cameras allow us to monitor the biological community and document food falls continuously for up to 1 year at a time. These types of long-term studies are essential for monitoring future ocean changes. This is Linda Kuhnz for the Monterey Bay Aquarium Research Institute.